Ah, what a beauty. The Ruthless. Well, I've got my sketchbook. I think I'll get started. I'm going to sketch her for a painting that I'm going to do later on, so I need as much detail as possible. Now, first of all, I'm going to actually block out the shape of the boat, just keep it very simple. Now, I didn't actually realise how tall the mast was. I don't think I've left enough room on my pad. Never mind. That's the guide ropes. I'm not going to draw all of them, just a few of them. And just leave a little gap so it looks like the light's catching the rope. Now I'm using an HB pencil, but actually I'm going to change to a 4B pencil as it's a little bit softer and it gives a nice dark line which really picks out some of the finer detail. Finished. Although actually it's just the beginning, because now I want to paint her in a more idyllic setting, and there's only one way to get there: by boat.
Ahoy there!
Ah, hi Mark.
Hi Martin.
How are you?
Hi Pete. Very good, thank you. Well, I'm all ship shape and Bristol fashion.
Great. Well, come aboard.
Oh, thank you. Right, here we go. Ooh, it's not as easy as it looks.
So, Martin, do you think there's enough wind to get the sails up?
Yeah, I think that's a good idea, Mark. We'll just wait till we get through the harbour entrance, and then we'll put them up. What? A little spot on the land and steer towards it.
Okay. Anchors away! Oh, now this is what I've come for. Just look at those chalk cliffs over there. They've actually eroded over time to form this really rugged coastline. And those rocks just there, that's old Harry and his wife. Well, half his wife. The other half fell into the sea, but still perfect for painting. First of all, I'm going to start off with the outline of the rocks. Just mark them out. Just to act as a guide for me, really. Get old Harry in and his wife. Right, I've got my cliffs in position. Now I need to draw the Ruthless. But I can't actually sketch it because I'm sitting on it. But if you remember earlier on, I did a sketch. And here it is. So that is going to be my guide. Lovely. Right, now to add some watercolours. Very appropriate as we're at sea. Just hope the rain keeps off. Okay, let's start on those cliffs first of all. See, with watercolours, it's best not to overwork them. Just being brave enough just to hold back and say, right, that's enough, that's enough. And I'm terrible for that. I'm going to leave those cliffs as they are. I don't want to overwork them. And what I'm going to do now is actually add a little bit of wax. There's a bit of candle wax here that I've fashioned into a point. I'm just going to rub it over the top of the cliffs, because what I want it to do is resist some of the wash I'm going to put on the background. Hopefully, it should give it some sort of texture as well. Right, let's get a wash down at the back here. Let's just get some foreground in. I need to make this area right at the base of the page quite dark, really. As the sea goes away, it gets lighter. So there you go, a watercolour landscape of Ruthless in front of old Harry and his wife. I wonder if that makes it a portrait.